والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومواله. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. Today's khatr, I will give the title, Don't Compare, but Focus on What You Have. What do I mean by this? We all aware that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold us accountable on the Day of Judgment. On what basis? Now, let's see the following beautiful basis of justice. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا ما آتاها. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا ما آتاها. Allah will not hold us accountable but with what He has already given us. Why am I highlighting this? Many people, they put themselves in a comparison which is unjust against themselves, and they will be feeling with a very bad negative feeling, which is not fair. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu circumstances that was not given to Bilal. Mus'ab bin Umair, he was given circumstances. He was the son of a mother and father, in our measurements, multi-millionaires. So he was so suitable to be the ambassador of Islam at Al-Madinah. Bilal radiallahu anhu, he was a slave. So at a certain point, he was the mu'adhin, but he was not the ambassador. So imagine if Bilal kept thinking, why Allah did not give me the money and the wealth of Mus'ab so that to be the ambassador? He will lose his life just feeling the bad feelings. What's the point? Why I'm saying that? Look, Abdullah Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Abbas, both of them, they are considered both one of the two great scholars of Islam. One of them is Turjuman of Quran, the translator of the Quran. How many battles he fought for the sake of Allah? We have no idea. But khamilwali, the sword of Allah, what kind of knowledge he presented to us? Nearly nothing. Look how beautiful. So, what was my message? Don't, for example, don't just look at Umar Khattab, oh my God, I have to be fighting all the enemies of Islam, Umar Khattab. No, maybe this is not your job. First step, Allah will ask you about what He has given you. Okay, first step, see what Allah gave you. If I was born in a house of politics and my father is a big politician or a minister, the power that I was given, that I have a huge networking and social power. So my job, maybe not necessarily to be a scholar in teaching the Quran. Okay? Or, if I have a very powerful body, like Habib, you know Habib? The MMA, Habib, okay, they say Habib, it's not Habib. Now Habib is not a scholar. Okay? He was not giving the donation. He's not a social worker. He was fighting. But in the field of fighting, he was raising what he can of the world. At least, you know, for example, when he stood and he refused to shake hands with nearly a naked woman by telling her that I'm sorry, I do not touch you, for example. Maybe it's little than 1,000 khutbah from someone like myself in his place. So imagine me comparing myself with Habib. Abu Khabib, I will lose the battle. It's not me. Okay? So, what's the message? Always to be always optimistic and feel very happy. Just compare yourself with yourself and compete with yourself. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you something specific for you. Keep developing yourself. Look at others, not in the sense of why I'm not to do exactly like him. This is a wrong comparison. Make dua for him. Take the benefit part of, then see your circumstances. Sometimes you might be like Abdullah ibn Abbas, or like Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, or Abu Bakr, or Umar ibn Khattab. Abu Bakr is greater than Umar al-Khattab, but Abu Bakr did not fight anyone in the way that Umar al-Khattab, he was always ready. دعني أغلب عن أخوة يا رسول الله. I'm ready. Abu Bakr did not do it. So, what is the final message? لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا ما آتاها. Be aware that Allah will ask you about what He has given you. So the message, please keep digging, discovering what you've been given from Allah. Or otherwise, if I did not pay attention to what I have, like there is a statement in Arabic, they say, يسافر الناس بعيدا بحثا عن الكنز وهو تحت أرجلهم. They say, some people that travel long distances away, searching for the treasure, while the treasure is exactly underneath their feet. I mean, by the way, this metaphorical statement was said in the context of the husbands and wife, which means the husband might be looking for other women because of the treasure is there, while his wife is the treasure. But unfortunately, he's not
seeing.
He's not paying the attention. So sometimes you need to stop, see, okay, what do I have? When you discover what you have, focus on what you have. You will be the greatest. JazakAllah khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us.